One day in late May, Gilbert came home to be met by Susan in the stable yard. "I'm afraid something has upset Mrs. Doctor, Doctor dear," she said mysteriously. "She got a letter this afternoon, and since then she has just been walking round the garden and talking to herself. You know it is not good for her to be on her feet so much, Doctor dear. She did not see fit to tell me what her news was, and I am no pry, Doctor dear, and never was. But it is plain something has upset her, and it is not good for her to be upset." Gilbert hurried rather anxiously to the garden. Had anything happened at Green Gables? But Anne, sitting on the rustic seat by the brook, did not look troubled, though she was certainly much excited. Her eyes were their grayest, and scarlet spots burned on her cheeks. "What has happened, Anne?" Anne gave a queer little laugh. "I think you'll hardly believe it when I tell you, Gilbert. I can't believe it yet. As Susan said the other day, I feel like a fly coming to live in the sun, dazed like. It's all so incredible. I've read the letter a score of times, and every time it's just the same. I can't believe my own eyes. Oh, Gilbert, you were right, so right. I can see that clearly enough now. And I'm so ashamed of myself. And will you ever really forgive me?"
"Anne, I'll shake you if you don't grow coherent. Redmond would be ashamed of you. What has happened?"
"You won't believe it. You won't believe it."
"I'm going to phone for Uncle Dave," said Gilbert, pretending to start for the house.
"Sit down, Gilbert. I'll try to tell you. I've had a letter. And, oh, Gilbert, it's all so amazing, so incredibly amazing. We never thought, not one of us ever dreamed—"
"I suppose," said Gilbert, sitting down with a resigned air, "the only thing to do in a case of this kind is to have patience and go at the matter categorically. Whom is your letter from?"
"Leslie. And, oh, Gilbert—"
"Leslie? Phew! What is she to say? What's the news about Dick?"
Anne lifted the letter and held it out, calmly dramatic in a moment. "There is no Dick. The man we have thought Dick Moore, whom everybody in Four Winds has believed for 12 years to be Dick Moore, is his cousin, George Moore of Nova Scotia, who, it seems, always resembled him very strikingly. Dick Moore died of yellow fever 13 years ago in Cuba.